Working with video can be a little difficult, even the most basic tasks. So I think this is a really cool tool. Nicola Nguyen Tin is here with me to tell you about Project Smooth Operator. Give him a warm welcome.
Smooth Operator. Smooth Operator.
Hi, everyone. How's everybody doing?
Good.
I'm super excited to be here. I'm also a little nervous, so bear with me. Here's, I want to start by showing you something. It's an aerial shot of a car driving through the desert. It's a really beautiful shot, isn't it? Here's the thing, though. When I try to publish this to Instagram stories, this is what I get. The car comes into view, and then immediately disappears. What's happening is that Instagram Stories expects a vertical video, but we gave it a horizontal one, and so it kept the center, discarded the sides, and this is what we're left with. The car is only visible for a couple seconds before it vanishes. It's not that great. To make this right, I have to go into Premiere and manually adjust things using keyframes and all that stuff. But that's a lot of work. What if, instead, we could identify the action and just follow it? This is what Project Smooth Operator does. So I'm processing the same video here. And the bright part that you see that is currently shifting to the left with the car, it's our crop. It's what makes it to the final output. What's happening is that Sensei is analyzing the video to determine the most important regions to include in the final output. And once processing is done, this is the result. Thank you. The car stays in frame. The output is still vertical, but we preserved the original content of the video. All right, let me show you another example of turning a horizontal video into a vertical one. This is an action shot of a skier doing a backflip. It's really impressive, so we want to make sure we capture this properly. And now that processing is done, here's the result. It's nice, right? Yeah. It feels very natural, although under the hood, the crop is swaying left and right to really follow the skier and capture that backflip 180. All right. Now, we all have videos on our phones that might be cool enough to post if things were in view, but maybe not important enough that we would edit them in Premiere. This is a video of my coworker Allison playing with her dog in the park. Now, I want you to take a second here to really appreciate what Sensei is doing for you. This is a video with multiple important regions. The crop switches between Allison and the dog and performs this natural panning to include both in the final output. And so we don't miss out on any important moments like Allison throwing the frisbee or the dog catching the frisbee. All right, let me show you one more example. This one is more extreme. It's a skydiving video. It's a really fast-paced video with a lot of action, with multiple people weaving in and out of frame. The camera comes close and goes far again, and it even goes upside down several times. Again, Sensei identifies the salient regions and seamlessly shifts the crop to include and retain the most essential parts of the video. And after processing, this is what we get.
Yeah.
Thank you. The output, this time we did one-to-one, so the output is square. And as you can see, we retain all the action in the video. With Project Smooth Operator, you can focus on jumping and not dying. We'll take care of making sure everyone makes it to the final video. Thank you.
Good stuff. Thank you, Nico.